The Blue Eddy Elite 400 is a big little power station. It's kind of in its own lane, which seems to be a trend for recent Blue Eddy releases, kind of like their Apex 300. With this power station's bigger battery yet smaller inverter, the specs on paper might not blow you away, but depending on your needs and expectations, this might actually be a really good unit for you. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Blue Eddy has recently made a comeback on the channel with their Elite 100 and 200 V2 power stations. And this one right here seems to be the bigger brother. It's the largest unit in the Elite lineup. We've had this unit here at the lab for a little while now, and we are ready to share our experience using this power station with you guys. As always, before we get into it, we have links in the description down below to this unit, as well as any discount codes that we can get out of Blue Eddy to help you guys save some money. We also have our power station quiz. So if you guys don't know exactly what power station you want, it's a 30-second quiz, gives you an instant recommendation on a unit that best fits your needs. But before we jump into all the things that we like and don't like on the Elite 400, we're gonna hit you with a super quick spec teardown in case you're not already up to speed with this brand new power station. First up, this thing passes the tiny baby lift test barely. It weighs about 85 pounds, which is almost his entire body weight. It has a 3,840 watt hour battery bank paired with a 2,600 watt inverter.
Tiny widow inverter.
In terms of getting power into this guy, it's got a regular 1800 watt AC input, so you could charge it up from a regular house plug inside of your home. It also has a 1000 watt solar input, which compared to the battery size is kind of low.
Kind of dinky.
Taking a look at the plugs and ports on this unit, we have four regular 120 volt house plugs. They are grouped a little bit tight together considering the amount of space there is on this unit. There's two USB A's and two USB C's on this unit. You have your 12 volt car socket. And then on the top, you actually have your solar input, which is very nice that it's on the front of the unit. On the side, you just have your AC input. That's how you get power into it from a house plug. The screen on this unit is nice. It's kind of like Blue Eddy's standard new screen. It's nice and bright. We really like it. And overall, the unit has a pretty good build quality. It's got your little suitcase handle hidden in the back. It's got your wheels so you can drag it around. You don't have to lift it. In case you're too weak, little baby, tiny baby can't whiff down a table. This unit does work with Blue Eddy's app. It's not the best app. It's a little bit slow and laggy when you're using it, but it gives you the ability to update the firmware and do a bunch of stuff that you can't do directly from the unit. And right now, this unit has just been released with a price of $14.99. With our discount code, this thing is currently $14.24.
Black Friday's coming too, it might even be cheaper.
The first thing that we really like about the Elite 400 is its design. It feels very robust. It's honestly got probably the best suitcase handle we've ever seen on a power station. It's very nice. It's got like a nice rubber grip and it's strong. A lot of times you have these suitcase handles and when you pull them out and you go to wheel the unit around, it feels flimsy. Like it feels like it's gonna break. This one feels super solid. The wheels are very nice and rubber, so they're not loud. And they also can take like kind of an impact, which is just nice. There's actually removable vents on the sides too. So you can go ahead and clean those to make sure this unit is breathing properly, which we really, really like. It's got nice big feet on the bottom, so it's properly planted when it's sitting here. It's not gonna slide around when you try to plug things into it. It's got nice big feet on the back, so you can lay it down. It even has a little rubber like kick plate where you can put your foot to kind of give it pressure to actually lay it down. They just did a good job designing this. This feels like a unit that's meant to be dragged around and used a lot, which is really cool because a lot of times you get these features on these units, but they don't feel like they would actually survive much outing. So this one does, and we really like that. We also really like the screen on this power station. We've noticed a lot lately, power stations are getting kind of like weaker and weaker screens. And when they're outdoors, it's kind of hard to read what's on them. And seeing that this unit is meant to be portable and taken around with you, the fact that the screen is nice and bright and also very clear and easy to understand is a huge pro for us. And we also really just like that this unit is not trying to be anything that it isn't, which is something we've said about some other recent Blue Eddy products as well. This power station feels like a small power station with a built-in expansion battery. A lot of power stations, they just make the inverters and the batteries similarly sized, and if you want a bigger battery, you have to add one on. This is a relatively small inverter, but it's got a decent sized battery when you compare to it. So you can actually get some good storage if you don't need a crazy output. And having a smaller inverter paired with a bigger battery actually lends itself to the final thing that we really like with this, which was the testing results. They were actually really good. This unit had a decent idle consumption. It's about 20 watts, which isn't terrible. There is other units in this category with better idle consumption by far, but seeing that it's paired with a much bigger battery, this unit, if you just had the AC inverter on and it was just sitting there idling, doing nothing, it would still last almost 8 days on a single charge, which is really good. It was about 77% efficient in our testing, and it charged from zero to full in 2 hours and 27 minutes, which lines up with kind of what we expected. The fans are nice and quiet. And when you're using this in UPS mode, something that we like is that it allows you to use more than you're inputting. A lot of power stations, if you're trying to use 2000 watts, but you're only charging at 1800, they cut you off at the 1800 watt range in terms of your load. This one will allow you to run 2000 watts while only inputting 1800, which is cool. Gives you flexibility when you're using it and still being able to keep it kind of powered up. Not all power stations do that, and so we do really like that. And the first thing that we really don't like about this power station is the solar input. The solar input being only 1,000 watts and the battery being almost 4,000 watt hours, it would take about 4 hours of perfect sun to charge this thing from zero to full, which doesn't sound terrible, but if you've ever been on the go, you're camping or whatever, you don't always even have a nice place to get sun. So being able to do it in 1 or 2 hours of good sun is a lot easier than 4 hours of good sun. We wish it had a little bit of a bigger solar input compared to the battery size. Another thing that we don't love about this is that it's built so perfectly to be durable and be able to take it around with you and travel with it. There's no light on this power station. Blue Yeti needs to start putting lights on their units. A light on something like this, you need two hands to pick it up and move it around. So if the power's out and you can't see, you have no light when you're doing that, trying to get up the stairs or whatever with this in your hands. But it's also meant to be portable and take it on the go. And so if you go to plug something into it or just use it in the dark, you have to use a light to see what you're actually doing on the unit, which does kind of suck. We also don't love Blue Yeti's support. It's not great. They don't actually have support. They have like sales support, so you can call them and kind of get help with what you're looking to buy.
Do you guys have a phone number I can just call tech support myself?
No, sir. Actually, you don't have the contact number.
But if you have an actual issue with the unit, you have to submit like an email ticket and wait 24 to 48 hours for a response. So if you end up having a problem with a unit like this, it does take a while to kind of get that problem sorted out, which we don't love. A lot of people see Blue Yeti as like a pretty big player in this space, so it would be cool if they leveled up their support a little bit. And the last thing we just don't like is the app. It's good, it's fine, it does what it needs to, but when you compare it to other apps for other brands, it is just a little bit slow and the features in there just are lacking a little bit. A lot of these other apps have cool storm detection features and peak shaving modes and stuff like that. Blue Yeti's app is just very basic. So who is this unit for? In our opinion, this is for someone who's looking to power some light loads during an outage. You could power your fridge with something like this for about 2 days. Or if you're trying to take it camping and need portable power and you want something that's got a little bit of a bigger battery that you can take on the go and you don't have to worry about recharging during a weekend trip or even a week-long trip because you have such a decent sized battery built into it. If your main focus is battery capacity, this is a good solution for you because a lot of times when you're looking at a unit and you want a bigger battery, you also have to size up the inverter on that power station to get the bigger battery. So in this case, you just go ahead and you still get your smaller inverter if that's all you need. 2600 watts will still do quite a bit. And you can get the bigger battery without having to get expansion batteries for a smaller unit or get a unit with an inverter that's way beyond what you need. So this could be a really good option if you're just looking for a small unit, but you want that extended storage. But that's pretty much all that we have for you guys today. Like we said earlier, there is coupons and links to this in the description down below, as well as the quiz. So if you're still not sure if maybe this is the unit for you or not, you can take the quiz, it takes 30 seconds, and it gives you an instant power station recommendation. Otherwise, that is all we got for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. We will catch you in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.